City Council meeting, January 17th, 2017. It's the second Tuesday of the month. It's the second meeting of the month. Third Tuesday of the month.
The time now is 4:59. We will begin our meeting promptly at 5 o'clock. We do ask that you take this minute to silence your cell phones, please, so that there won't be any interruptions once we begin our meeting. You have 1 minute. Please do so at this time. We thank you all for coming out this evening. The time now is 5 o'clock. Hopefully everyone had an opportunity to silence your cell phones. We're going to begin our meeting tonight, as always, with prayer by Pastor Gary Houston, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance. If you would, please stand with us.
Good evening. Let us pray together. Gracious Father, we come, we pause. Come through another day. We thank you for grace. We thank you, dear God, for mercy. We approach your throne. We realize, Lord, that every day is a day of thanksgiving. And so we say thank you today for all your many blessings. We pray tonight that you will guide the council as decisions are made. We pray, Lord, for the mayor in his absence. We pray for each department head. We pray that you will bless City of Meridian. Lord, may you cover this place with the precious blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So today we pause to say thank you, because truly you've been good to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Agenda. We're going to remove item number 7 for further review. It's also been brought to our attention that there is a need for a possible executive session, so we will add that to for a closed determination whether or not we'll stay in that. Are there any other amendments to the agenda? All in favor? Any opposed? All right, consent agenda.
Second.
All in favor? Any opposed? Routine item number 1. Orders authorizing reappointments to the Meridian Municipal Election Commission. Catherine Jones, 1 year. George Culpepper, 2 years. Rick Intrican, 3 years. Mary Wilson, 4 years.
Madam President, this is some routine appointments that we have in the Municipal Election Commission. And the reason you see those years that are staggered there, past appointments did go all up for 4-year terms. And this has been an effort to bring those back to staggered terms. These 4 individuals are currently on the Municipal Election Commission. And we ask for their reappointment for the upcoming municipal election.
Someone talk to each one of them, make sure they're good.
Yes, sir. We have talked to each one of them. We do have on here Ms. Catherine Jones, Mr. George Culpepper, and Rick Intrican that did help with the referendum that passed here recently. They did an amazing job, and we feel like we couldn't have a better municipal election commission in these
the City of Meridian Employee Council.
Move approval.
Madam President, the Employee Council has been around for about 30 years. We ask that we pass this resolution, which is authorize the enactment and make this an official council with the City of Meridian. I know we've had a few work sessions regarding the Employee Council, but we do feel there is a need for an Employee Council and for the individuals that do serve on that council as well. They have been meeting with the City Attorney, Will Simmons, and we feel that after we've gone through their information that it's going to go a point where we need to establish this entity as being an official City of Meridian entity.
Questions?
I'd like to quick comment. I want to thank Mr. Simmons for his efforts. I also want to thank the Employee Council for their patience and work and working with Mr. Simmons in order to get the bylaws, which I think we'll take action on next, hammered out, and also being attentive and in attendance at the work sessions.
The only, just for clarification, the version of the Employee Council bylaws that you have in your package there, those originally generated based on back to being reconstituted as opposed to starting fresh, so we just need to take a revision language out. Other than that, it would be exactly as you see it. So what we're proposing is it be exactly as it's in your package, you can strike the revision language, which is at the second of the top of the package. That's the only difference. So I just want to make sure you know that's what you're passing, because that's what I'm going to send to Joanne here to put in the minutes.
There's something they pass that we don't like, and we'll start. What does that come down to? If the Employee Council passes something we don't agree with,
they make recommendations to you, Mr. Hammond. I mean, the way I read the bylaws, I don't work on is that, in essence, if they have complaints or they have suggestions, things that should be changed, and then they will make those recommendations or. And present them.
No official action can be taken by the Employee Council without being approved by the City Council. They simply act as a intermediary between city employees and the administration, and they will bring forth any suggestion that they may have regarding policy to the administration, which we would then bring to you for a vote.
I was on an employee committee one time, and we better throw ourselves around.
There's no money involved.
They can vote on anything they want, Mr. Hammond, that you have to approve.
Gotcha.
Mr. Dr. Thomas, I have a question.
No, sir. Captain Thomas, there is no compensation involved.
Same as everybody.
Yes, sir. That's correct.
Any other comments or concerns? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you. Ticket item number 3. Order adopting the City of Meridian Employee Council bylaws.
Move approval.
With the changes I just made.
And first, in the purpose part there, talked about taking a look at their concerns to the City of Meridian administration and part of the Meridian City Council. But they know anyway. Doesn't have to go to mayor. I have some concern there. I just now noticed.
Would you rather go to the administration first, and then if it can't be solved on that level, go to the City Council?
I would. That's the administration's job.
Well, then why don't we try to say that?
They can't deal with it there, and then come to the council. That makes sense.
So we can put those revisions in. Do we need to? We can just word that tonight as such that we'll approve it with that change in language.
That's fine.
Okay. All in favor? Any opposed? Routine item number 4. Order authorizing memorandum of agreement between the 186 Air Refueling Wing and the City of Meridian Public Safety Training Facility.
Second. Madam President, this is a MOA between 186 Air Refueling Wing, air refueling wing at City Meridian. This is something that Director Roberts has been working very hard on, and he's here to answer any questions that you may have regarding that memorandum of agreement.
Good evening. It's mostly on the weekends after hours. They know gun usage. It's where they use the facility and all of our property to do different type of training. This has been going on. This is about the fifth or sixth time that I know it's been going on. It started with Monkey with the director out there. Been going on for the city.
Any additional questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you. Item number 5 was tabled in our previous meeting, and we just need a motion.
We'll just take it off the table.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Routine item number 5, order authorizing acceptance of bid from Puckett Machinery for a roller.
Move approval.
Second.
Madam President, as you just stated, this was tabled from the previous meeting. This will be accepting a bid for this bulldozer that we do have a definite need for, and some of the construction that's going around the city for infrastructure improvements. And Director Smith has worked from the call to bring this to fruition. He's available here if you have any questions regarding this acceptance of the bid.
Good evening, Captain. As the attorney says, needs spec for the name, justification sufficient.
Point, not the lowest bid.
Any additional questions or concerns? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Well, any idea when we can get it? I believe they have a unit on the yard, so it's all I'm asking you to get it for you.
This is also a convenience located here in Meridian, so shopping local there.
Routine item number 6, order authorizing memorandum of understanding for financing of the E911 CAD system.
Move approval.
Second.
Madam President, this is something that we have gone through several work sessions on, we do know that there is a need for this updated software with E911. This is a partnership between the city and the county. We have also discussed some partnership discussion items that come up as far as splitting some service as far as IT, but the city feels that at this point it would be in our best interest to move forward with turning this before the council for a vote. If you have any questions, I believe we have Jared Stanley here to answer any questions.
No problem buying equipment. I do have a problem. Service agreement, 2 pages for what? City provides X amount of support. What does the county and the town of Meridian pay to the city of Meridian? What does E911 pay to the city for those kind of services? We're going to maintain the backup. If the city's going to do that, then our part of the agreement should be less financially than the other sides. I have a lot of questions about those which we've discussed before, and I'm based on good faith. Work these things out. I know we need to put that, but I think there's some agreements on who's responsible for what, who pays for what. In my opinion, it's not fair for the present time to sit and wait.
Which is the amount that we allocated this year, the 100,000, that's a part of school.
The 100,000 has already been allocated and has been applied to this. But
it's a lease for what, 5 years?
It's a 5-year lease, but as Dr. Thomas said, we would be bringing this before you that we're working in good faith with the county to address some issues as far as staffing, usage, manpower, and reimbursement. So,
about a year ago, Jared asked about a technician to maintain the system. Do you have that?
Mr. Hammond and also Dr. Thomas falls under the same thing. We do not have that technician in place, but that is the discussion that's taking place in the background right now. While the funding needs to take place so that the system can actually be purchased, what we are looking forward to do moving forward through the 911 Commission is establishing those guidelines that make sure that the responsibilities for maintaining the system. First and foremost, fall upon the vendor that we're purchasing it from. But should anything need to be done at the local level, the easy way to say it is to make sure that the city takes care of city things and the county takes care of county things, and we're not asking for the city of Meridian to monitor and maintain county equipment or vice versa. And make sure there's no undue burden past what's already established.
So they're going to take care of the maintenance and the technician?
Correct, sir. We're talking in the 911 Commission. The day after the last work session, we had a 911 Commission meeting, and we spoke about the need to sit down and hash this out. The 911 Commission attorney, Mr. Reed Darcy, advised that it was his recommendation that the 911 Commission form an MOU specifying those divisions of requirements whose responsibilities fall onto which pieces of equipment. And so we're working very closely with the IT manager for the city, Mr. Dan Talbert, and also Rob Wilson with the county to make sure that both sides' needs are met and form that MOU out of the 911 back to the city council so that you can approve.
How long do you think that's going to take, ballpark?
Just for clarity's sake, there won't be anyone being hired to do IT work until we've brought this back before the council, correct?
That's correct.
That way we can decide together as a joint entity how much funding would be spent. But as of right now, our plans are to utilize in-house IT services with Mr. Talbert and our attorney folks to help get this thing going, and then we'll bring this back to you for approval.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you.
Thank you.
We're going to take item number 8, claims docket.
We did have a few questions regarding the claims docket, but I believe
what I asked.
Okay.
Thank you, Ben.
Is there any other questions?
Any additional comments, concerns? All in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Presentation agenda, notification of legal advertisement for the following, street resurfacing phase 2. Second item, mayor's report.
Thank you, Madam President. Mayor Bland right now is in Washington, D.C. He's meeting with our congressional delegation, and he's working on the route that we need to go to obtain infrastructure funding for the city of Meridian. What we're looking to do is tie in 8th Street, rehab program for the 8th Street portion from the 4-lane to 22nd Avenue, in which case we would like to be putting lines in the ground and also alleviating some traffic concerns. That will be part of our master plan for the future. But we hope that the funding for that could possibly come from a Tiger Grant proposal that we hope to be submitting to USDOT. We've got a great
one.
Sir?
Corner across from First Baptist Church. That property was secured by the city to straighten that out so you don't have to make a left turn and right turn to go straight.
Yes.
Unlike that. While we're redoing 8th Street, we mean, look, fixing that.
Yes. That's another point we have here is master planner Bob Luke and LPK. Architects have been meeting with stakeholders in the community to get input on what we want this master plan and the city to look at. It is encompassing a great area, but we know that we have traffic concerns, we have infrastructure concerns, and we also have some funding concerns. But we feel like that we have a great team in place now with our master plan, and that we're going to have a clear path moving forward that can tie all this together. I want to say that we had a great MLK celebration this weekend, and we thank everyone that participated in honor of what Dr. King stood for, and we appreciate everyone that took part in that event. We have some great news about the recent information that came in about special revenue collection for arts and entertainment. It did come in higher than what we were expecting. So that shows the strength of our local economy, and as Arch McDonald says here, the power of local. People are investing in their community by shopping more. Director Magruder has done an amazing job at James Chambers Park. He has 95% of the equipment installed at James Chambers Park, and he also has four brand new scoreboards put up at Phil Hartman. The rest of the ballpark will be put in here in the near future, couple months. So Mr. Magruder has done a great job getting that taken care of and being proactive. We recently had a community event at Central Fire Station. It was a great event. We appreciate Chief Clayton, Chief Lester, and his team getting everybody together. Fire Marshal Jason Collier, everybody helping put that together to show the community what goes on at your local fire department, as well as giving young children the ability to see what really happens there, to maybe look at making career choices there. A lot of great things going on in the city. I appreciate everything the council approved and the opportunity to speak. Thank you.
On the infrastructure, Mississippi Municipal League is taking a big push. The state legislature is considering infrastructure funding. One of the pushes is to have some of that money. They found that the more city and county streets have been repaired than highways. City people out there in the audience can support that. The state legislature mentioned that, and representatives of the state legislature, that if they do that package, there could possibly be more money for municipal and county governments, and not just for state highways.
Dr. Thomas, we're extremely fortunate that Mr. Tommy Delaney is on a infrastructure subcommittee with the state, and they are focusing on using some of that funding for local infrastructure as well as bridge repair.
All right, thank you. Next item is on the agenda is our citizen comments. We have three people signed up for tonight. We do ask that you be mindful that you have 3 minutes to address the council. First is Mr. Alan Chu.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Alan Chu, glad you gave me some time to cool off. It's all flat and $129,000 in bulldozer. Your city attorney justified it. Rolled $13,000 over the lowest bid. I don't know how you justified it, but the city, the general attorney, and the ethics committee is going to know about it. So, I really hope all 5 years to go to jail. It's what you did was illegal, or should be illegal. Thought, but we better find out. And it's not illegal, and I'm pretty sure the citizens of this town ain't gonna like you spending $13,000 for a higher bid just because their buddy's down their pocket wants to sell you a bulldozer. That is totally ridiculous. How you can justify that? I don't know how. I'm not even keeping straight. I read it out. This is a poor city. Why don't you have a bus service? If you want to spend more money, you have to for a bulldozer. I'm really looking forward to seeing how you guys justify that. We heard at the last meeting, you tried to justify it because you don't have to take it to the accident to get the oil change. I'll tell you what, when you buy something like that, the warranty goes away. Any cat dealership will change the oil. You really think you're going to save $13,000 just because you're going to change the oil down here at Bucket? This is really interesting. How do you guys get away with this all over now? Well, one way, this is the second meeting of the month. Now, as far as I know, this ain't going to be broadcasted anywhere. It's going to be put on a CD if you want, and then go down to the public. But anybody watching or hearing about this meeting, you can go to my webpage, alanchief.com, right here. And this will be on the webpage. We'll be recording the whole meeting will be on there so people can see it. And it's about time I started getting mad at this. 3 weeks ago, it was $93,500 for a master plan. No bid. Just give it to your buddies. That's a joke. And I'm here, and I'm going to say it out loud. I'm ashamed of each and every one of you. I'm ashamed. And I look forward to campaigning against anybody who wants to run against you. Have a good day.
Thank you, Mr. Schutt. Next person we have is Mr. Walter DeMears. Is he present? Third is Mr. Rod Brown. Next thing on our agenda is council comments.
Seems like I'm always left to answer some of the stuff that happens to the council, but I don't have any problem doing it. When I worked for people, we had multi-million dollar equipment. And you don't even start to understand what the maintenance on that equipment. But for more than that, I trust Hugh Smith. He's a chemical engineer. He knows what he needs to do the job, and we are doing the job. This is the first time in 20 or 25 years that we have a road program, first time in the year that we've spent millions of dollars on our infrastructure. So as far as I'm concerned, the money's going where it's supposed to go, and the taxpayers know that. They also know when somebody doesn't have enough evidence or enough facts to deal with the facts. I
echo Randy's comments. I want to thank everybody who came out to the MLK Day of Service at Family Young Park. We had almost 20 Mississippi Power volunteers, 7 members of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. Mr. Eddie Kelly and Ms. Annie McMillan worked with me to put this together. I want to give a special thanks to Mr. Kevin Magruder for making the Family Young Center accessible. And allowing us to get over there yesterday and scope that park. Very good time. We're going to try to make it an annual thing. So thank you.
All right. Well, good evening. We are so glad to have everybody come out tonight. I just want to give kudos to Delta Sigma Theta sorority, one of the greatest sororities, the sorority. We have a special group of young people here tonight that when I ask them to stand, we just want to recognize you. These are our Delta Gems, Delta Debutantes. They're impacting this community in strong and mighty ways. These are the future leaders of Meridian, and we're just delighted to have them here with us tonight. Ms. Wright or Ms. Hickman, did y'all have something that you wanted to say?
Thank you for having us.
All right. We will be meeting to see if we'll have an executive session, so if y'all can sit tight, I will be with you shortly afterwards. All right. At this time, we need to have a determination motion on whether or not we will go into executive session. Concerning economic development, potential litigation, and possible action to follow.
So moved. Second.
All in favor? Any opposed? Thank
Take
you all.
Yeah.
Ms. Wright, could y'all watch my son? Y'all gonna be out there, Mr. Houston? And if you all could exit the building, not the building, but just exit the room.